was ugly. I'm a bitch. She was a prostitute. She told her about Marsha B. Johnson.
Well, she talked about how she thought she met Marsha, like, I don't know, she was, like, very young. I mean, I think she was, like, she'd already been out on the street for maybe, I think it was less than a year.
So she went out, she was 12, so 12 or 13 years of age.
Yeah.
She meets this old queen of 18.
Was like, yeah, the thing is that what happened was she said that they started out where Marsha was her mother and was, like, showing, basically showed her the ropes, and she... I don't know what else.
And how to survive.
And Marsha had a job also. She worked in some kind of...
Oh, right. They worked together in food service for a while.
She was a waitress. Marsha was a waitress in a restaurant.
Right.
Anyway, over time, she said that... Sylvia said that Sylvia became more like Marsha's mother. So they kind of, like, changed roles.
One time Marsha saved her life.
Yeah, well, at least once.
Do you remember her description of that?
All I remember is that Sylvia was like in the bathtub, and she had cut her veins in the bathtub, and she had blood dripping out of her, and she was dying. And Marsha just, like, I guess knew that something was wrong for some reason, and so she came to the apartment, and, like, somehow she got in, and she banged on the bathroom door, and she, you know, burst in and saved her life. So
they swore at that time that they would cross the River Jordan together.
Yeah, now, right. And that's what that's why Sylvia didn't believe Marsha had committed suicide, was because Marsha had always promised her that they would die together, go across the River Jordan together. So
on the way they did, because Sylvia was wearing the Marsha button I just gave you. And so, in a way, they were in the coffin together, and they should have burned that button up with Sylvia.
I'm not able to go further than this right now, okay?
Okay, well, listen, it's been wonderful. I'm so glad. Have you enjoyed Hoboken? Would you endorse Hoboken as a tourist destination to those people who are thinking of going somewhere interesting and fun?
I would say that you come to this apartment. Get to know
I didn't ask for that! No, the apartment is closed!
Look at this beautiful, decorated place.
You can have the ceiling. You can show the ceiling only.
Michael can tell jokes, and you guys can all watch your J-pop.
Oh, you made an offer. I want to make it on camera, because you said that when you got back to Portland that you were going to pay for Michael and I to fly to visit you in Portland.
No, I'm going to pay for you.
And I said I never had a butch lesbian sort of be a sugar mama to me, and that I was going to get you to make that offer to me, and I was going to accept it. I'll probably end up paying it my own or both our fares, but why don't you make that offer so we can make it, like, official.
Let's do it together. I will invite you and Michael and John Gallagher.
Yeah.
You can all come see me, and I will entertain you, and I'll cook, and I will
wash my laundry.
I will not
like
wash
a good female
laundry.
Should.
No, but
no,
I'll show you the nightlife of Portland. I'll show you the nightlife of Portland.
I'm too old for nightlife. I sleep in the night. I want to see the daytime Portland. I want on a walk by the river when the sun is rising, with my healthy, thin,
we all stay in the
newly
same hotel room.
Non-psychotic, on her medications, Julia, which you're obviously not mental. Oh, and I have permission. This we're going to make as a copyrighted tape, and I'm going to make sure that you're paid for any use that it's put to. Is that agreeable? You trust me on that, right?
I want a $10 consideration, that's all.
$10. Okay, I'm negotiating on your behalf. So you just give me the rights to do with it, and trust me that I'll do.
Okay, right. I trust you.
You're a real,
well, that was
you're
stupid.
A real
God.
Fool. Yeah, because everyone knows I'm a real operator. And if I wanted to, could I put this interview up, say, on Vimeo, and maybe make it limited by password to some few people that might be interested in seeing it? Because I don't want to hand it over to, like, some of the people that are making a documentary on you and Sylvia, because I'm afraid that somehow I'll probably get you to sign some copyright just so I supposedly have rights to it.
You can show it on Vimeo, or
I want to share it with the world. When I die, my directions is that everything that I own, all my videos, all my pictures, everything become public domain. Because, I'm supposedly a genius in media manipulation. According to Duberman, I'm really not a genius, but I do know how to manipulate the media. And by doing that, I'm not clinging to every little thing I ever owned to get make sure I get my last dollar out of it. By giving it to everyone, I might have an open contest at a film school and say, $10,000 reward the person that makes the most interesting documentary about Marsha B. Johnson, Sylvia Rivera, or me, or all three of us, or anything you want to do, and have them all run around and all get educated about trans issues when they're young. And when they get old and wealthy in Hollywood, they'll say, I have an idea for a great movie. It's a story of Julia and Sylvia going to Rome and staying in the anarchist fort. I mean, no, first being graciously hosted in a big thing by the transsexual community, and then being turned over to the anarchists in the fort and being sheared there, and then turned over to the official new gay pride parade of the millennium, the first one. It was in January of 2000, the first great world celebration of gay pride, where Julia was greeted, had thousands of people cheering her, and said, I never knew I had so many children. What a fantastic movie!